Hello everyone. I think few people know me here because from here in campus for a long time. Not very long time, but long time. I did my MA in communication from school, 12-14 batch. And right now, I'm pursuing PG Diploma in Human Rights. It's a one-year distance course. And first thing, I thank all the people, like within the campus student community and professors and civil society, all the people whoever supported the movement or supported the people whoever are inside the jail and whoever campaigned for them to come out. I thank each one of them very much. So it is very important for us, like as we are inside the jail, it is very important for us because we never know when we are coming out. So in the same way, there are so many people, right? There are so many political prisoners who are in jails and like they're not coming out from so long time. Only with this support we came out, otherwise it is not possible, right? Yeah. Thank you so much. And second thing, on the day the incident happened, right, 22nd, I went to write my exam. I have this PG diploma exam, right? So it's from 10:30 to 1:30, and after that I came here and I got to know that VC Appa Rao came to campus. I never thought that he will come, but somehow he dared to come. So like as we are already, we know, right, like there is some kind of strong BJP, TRS, TDP backup from behind. Like he simply cannot come to campus, right? So like today only I'm hearing so I also teach in a college, right? So one of my professor PLB is telling, he lodged a petition in State Human Rights Commission. So I met him today. What he is telling me is, I spoke with Appa Rao, he came to SHRC. So he is telling this, Appa Rao is very crude and I don't think he has any intention to leave the campus. Right, so he is telling this point to me. So I told like, see, he will not go, he will not leave campus, but we'll throw him out of campus. Like, he will not go. Obviously, see, there are so many, some people say that he paid a lot of money to get this. Yeah. So, if at all it is true, like, he will not leave without earning money, right? So, it is very evident that he is not there in campus for the student community. See, ultimately one point what I want to say is about Appa Rao. Even Appa Rao or the faculty or non-teaching faculty, all these people are there in campus only for the student community, right? End of the day. Just because students are there in campus, they are there. Otherwise, like it will become some forest or playground, whatever. So, that is one thing. And still, I cannot believe that guy came again to campus. And in this one thing what we should keep in mind is, obviously, see, there is a lot of political support pouring for both the people who are doing the movement and for the people who are against the movement also. Like Appa Rao or like the ABVP people. Like, see, that day I saw in the day 22nd, I saw when non-teaching faculty, when they're taking a rally from here against the protest, one ABVP guy is leading. He's standing and he's doing, I was getting shocked, like, thoda sharam rahe na, like, karne ke liye. Like, they should be knowing what they are doing, and just with a blank mind he's doing. So, like, which most of the people who are in ABVP has blank mind, or maybe they think they're something or whatever it is. See. And see, it is as OYC told, right? OYC, when he met all the students in jail, right? He told this point. It is a war, whatever is going on. And it will not end. Like, it will be there for a long time. Like, this is not going to end even Appa Rao goes or whatever. It will be there for a long time, and the struggle will go on for a long time, even if Appa Rao is going also. Because if Appa Rao is going, there are so many Appa Raos who are like with that kind of mindset in this campus. So I think you are very sure, I guess, like whoever are there in campus, but they are not coming out. They are just looking for one right time. Like Appa Rao, he became a VC, he showed his like true color very explicit in a very explicit way, right? Now like other people also will we'll do that, and we should resist that one, that kind of forces, right? Like that kind of casteist forces. It is very important for us to do. See, ultimately Rohit's struggle is to stop that people to discriminate, like whatever discrimination he faced, right, throughout his life. Ultimately he struggled to end caste discrimination, right? And we are not telling our upper caste people to come to the lower level or whatever, but we are just fighting for some kind of equality, right? End of the day we want that, like we don't want any discrimination to happen. And there are also few people from outside campus especially. Like what they say is, do you think still discrimination is, like, does it exist in campus? Bolto, yeah, for sure it is existing in campus. Very much it is existing, and in a subtle way they are doing, in an open way they are doing. The people who are smart, or people like who are not smart, like they're like facing it in different ways. And my point is, it is still there in campus in a very good way. Like students are getting discriminated, right? So maybe some people are not aware also that they are getting discriminated, right? So that is one thing. And now I want to speak about campus security, whatever is there, right? Presently in University of Hyderabad, all the students, faculty, non-teaching, I don't know again. Faculty, most of the faculty, students are very concerned about the campus security. How security is there, right? Like they are getting panicked when the security CISF, they are going to come to campus. It seems now, it's there in the minutes. CISF, they are going to deploy, or there will be police people everywhere. So I don't know. See, maybe now we are there in this campus, and some police, till now we got a lot of freedom, right? So suddenly police people are coming, we are getting panicked. But one thing what we should keep in mind, or what we already know, is there are already a lot of police people or army people in Kashmir University or in Manipur University. See, they're already experienced. So now we are saying that police people are coming, we are panicked. Well, those people will be thinking from Manipur or Kashmir, these people, now they know. When police people come, now they know. Oh, I mean, how it will be. So I mean, we should acknowledge always, right? Like I think most of the people know about this particular point, okay? See, about the police people in this country are never there to protect. Their agenda is very larger. Like they don't join the police force to protect the people. Like there are so many serious cops, and have some kinds of respect for the people who seriously work for the people, but still the politicians will not make them work for the people. And I'm very sure it's happening. And I think police force, however, like in whatever way they are helping people, or like their job is to serve people only, obviously, not helping also. Like more than serving the common people, they're serving the people of, like, who are more, I don't know how to put also, like politicians or bureaucrats or like some elite people, only they're serving more than the common people. Like the place where we stayed in Miapur station, right? There a few people came to the station. Like we stayed there till next day afternoon, 22nd evening we got picked up, right? So we stayed there till 23rd afternoon, and from 23rd afternoon we were taken to Banner police station. So in this time I saw police personnel conversation with different people, how they speak with people, right? So like the way they speak with people who come from some slum, or the way they speak with people who are not educated, is very different and very discriminative than the way they speak with people who come in cars, or people who come in good clothing, or like that difference. Like they are discriminating in a way, they are also discriminating. And yeah, that is there about people. So, and I'm more critical about what happened only on that day, right? Like on 22nd, the way the 18 people, especially in this bus, I don't know about the 9 people who went in other vehicle, ambulance, they went from campus. these 18 people, they were abused in a very vulgarest or vulgar way. Like, we cannot imagine that kind of thing from the police personnel who is serving the public, right? Like, very vulgar language. They were speaking that, are you people eating like Pakistani people shit or what? Why are you supporting Afzal Guru or Yaqub Maimon or what is wrong with you people? We'll not let you people live when you come outside. Or do you know how to become a VC? They are asking. Like, we can say, like, if you have money, you can become or whatever. But at the time, someone is saying that, we already, compared to other people who are there in the bus, right? I got beaten in, less only. Like, I was sitting in the first row of the bus. And there is one senior officer beside me, so all these people didn't come, to me very much. But I got very less beatings compared to the people who are behind. Like, behind all the people, they were beaten very, 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 very brutally. Like, I'm, at least to see that side also, I'm panicked. If I see that side again, they'll say, "Arey, you're not getting, that's why you're looking vulgar." Again, they'll beat me also. That, we got scared, we got panicked the way they are beating. Like, at least I thought that when we are in the bus only, these people are beating like this. When they take us to the police station, right? I thought they may kill all of us. Like, at least that, at one point of time, I got that striked in my head, okay? So the abusers, whatever they hurled at all the people, are very abusive, and that says that how police people are, how foolish they are, in a direct way, how foolish they are, how unaware they are, or how uneducated, whatever, I don't know, something is, there is some problem with the police forces, especially the people who are in that bus or that special force, I guess. Special force. Most of the people, I think they write the 12th exams or whatever, and they come to this job, I guess. They are not aware. It is the job of the government to make them aware what is the scenario of the country, right? Okay. And second thing, in campus, if you are talking again, there are a lot of people who are supporting students again in a subtle way or in an explicit way. Some faculty are supporting Appara also, so that's very saddening actually. People over are supporting Appara, if not directly or in a subtle way, they also have some, they are expecting some kind of favors from the VC. Some kind of favors will be there, even non-teaching faculty also simply are the foolish people or what, they are going to get something. And all these days, see, in the students union or the student organizations, other except ABVP, I can say, are always in support with the non-teaching faculty. At least, from whatever I'm seeing from past few years or before that also, students are the one who are supporting non-teaching faculty from long time, right? So I don't know, suddenly they are changing their stand, they have a lot of reasons for that too. They're also going to get a lot of favors from VC. That's why they are supporting. So we should know that people are selfish basically here. That we should see. People are selfish who are supporting VC upper. Otherwise, why we want police in campus? Otherwise, we don't want, right? Even though campus is getting destroyed, these people are supporting me. Something is wrong with them. The culture of campus, what is existing in this university right now, how democratic this space is, or how democratic this space, right? So we are going to lose it. Still these people are supporting, so there is something wrong. So one thing everyone should keep in mind, whoever are here, or is all this movement, whatever is happening, is because of Rohith Vemla. Other than Rohith Vemla, it is not possible. Because of him only, this movement is happening, and we should go in the path how Rohith, whatever he thought, right? We should go in that same path, and we should struggle, fight for justice, okay? That I think I request every single person who are here to know the story of Rohith and how he struggled in campus and what are his aims. I want everyone to know about that and just please follow it, okay? And he's never selfish, Rohit. He has more larger agendas, okay, to achieve. And see, outside campus also this perception is there in most of the people. We are always concentrating inside campus. Campus mein kya ho raha, it's very important for us. See, campus struggles are always popular, it changed so many governments, right? But sometimes I think we should also concentrate on the people who are outside campus, in the common crowd. See, when we are making them educated only, then the government will... It is very important, right? Only campus students or campus faculty or social networking is not enough. We should go ultimately to the people who are out there. So in this regard, I want all the campus people to go at least outside campus in Hyderabad. I don't know about other places, but at least in Hyderabad, there are so many like slum areas. So many are there, we should go there, educate them what exactly is happening. What exactly is the agenda of the BJP government, how they want to destroy or how they want to suppress people, we should, or even TRS government also in that sense. They are also part of BJP now. Like it's very like evident throughout whatever happened in campus, right? Telangana police people are there inside campus, right, that day. Telangana police only bet all the students, so they are involved. TRS is involved basically, we cannot keep TRS aside now, okay? So we should, I want all the student community to also take this Rohit Vemula moment outside campus. It is very important for us, okay? And talking about the jail, see, jail, now whatever is happening in campus, I think jail is a bit better, I feel, in a way. Or almost equivalent. If not, jail is better, almost they are like same, in a way. Both our campus and the Chelapalli Central Prison, they are almost equivalent. But however we are, in a way, we are sitting so freely here, but that thought is there in our mind that police people are there here, they're not allowing some people from outside, even though politicians or social activists, they're not allowing, right? So that is similar kind of environment is there in here and in jail also. See, there is a, like, we are going to face the future of the so-called India is not... it's not going in a right way, see. Because see, in India, I don't know, BJP always want to victimize the Muslims in a... primarily Muslims, they want to always victimize. See, even though, see, the campus may... whatever happened in our campus, right? So it... Rohit Vemula died. But all this happened, but still end of the day, they want to blame again Muslims only. End of the day. But they are not... See, If the government is always blaming the Muslim community, right, I don't think it is right at all. It's not, I don't think, but it's very wrong, whatever is happening, and we should change this kind, and this kind of thought is also some common public outside also has this thought. This Muslim means, like, they're getting some kind of negative thought. That is because of the government propaganda and that Hindutva media, whatever is there. So as an educated university people, I think we should change that perception of what people are and what BJP is trying to do. I think we should do that. Otherwise, this country is going to, so-called India is going to, it will destroy one day, like totally. It will not, like Achhe Din is never going to come. So-called Modi ka Achhe Din will never come. He is always trying to victimize Muslims, SCs, STs, BCs or whatever. So it is, So it is going to happen. One day the country will get destroyed for sure if this is happening. And I thank all of you for supporting this Rohit Vemula movement, and we will struggle more to get justice for Rohit, and we should also strive hard to get Rohit Act. So that is the ultimate thing. If that act is coming in future, if there is something right, like we can fight through that act. Otherwise, again, same scene will continue. Again, people will get discriminated. Same thing will continue. So I request all the people to struggle for Rohit Act and like make it possible. like use your all contacts in different universities, or there are so many people from different states, right? So like put some kind of pressure in social media or to the government, and like we'll make it possible, okay? So thank you so much for giving this chance, opportunity.